Hi guys, I'm going to try to keep this short, sweet, and concise and basically cover Facebook trainings. To start off, I just want to say that whether you are having your kickoff party or a holiday party or a spring fling or back to school, or maybe you haven't had a party in a while and you kind of need a restart or a jump start, this is a great way to kind of get the party season going, whether it's initially or you're getting back into the swing of things. Facebook parties are so much fun, and they're so easy to do. And a little bit later, I'm going to talk about how they're even easier than we thought they were. Because of how easy these parties are, I like to call them my stress-free, mess-free parties. There's no stress of, oh, when am I going to squeeze 2 to 3 hours into my day, and what am I going to do with my kids while I have the party, or where am I going to have it, or, oh my gosh, I have to clean my house before, and then I have to clean my house again after. There's none of that. None of it at all, because I can schedule this in a smaller time frame. I can do the invites just a few days in advance. I don't have to worry about what I'm going to do with my kids, what my house looks like, what I'm going to feed people. I'm not responsible for any of that. All I have to do is share our amazing books and answer questions that people might have and encourage them to shop. So stress-free, mess-free, super easy, tons of fun. You get to party in your PJs. What's better than that? So, again, whether it's your kickoff or you just need a reason to have a party, have a Facebook party. You could be doing these, once a month if you wanted. Trust me, I've had multiple Facebook parties, and I'm getting ready to have another one in a few days. So, let's talk about how do we actually get this Facebook party started and what do we do. First thing, if you've never created a party or event on Facebook, it's pretty simple. On your homepage, on the left-hand side, you will see events. You click on it, you'll see where you can create, and this little box will pop up and walk you through every little step from what you want to call it, what it's about, what time, where. Really simple. And I have either created one for all of you or done one for you in the past, so you now know what they look like, and so you just use that as your model for future parties that you set up on your own. Okay, so now you've created the event and saved it. Second thing, hop on over to your website, go to your e-commerce site, and you want to go to your account, and then you want to click on where it says add event. Again, very simple. It's going to ask for the date, your name, or the hostess's name, depending on whether this is your own party or somebody else's, and an email if you want. Really simple. And you save it. At some point, we're going to connect that to the Facebook party. But so now you have your Facebook event created. You have your e-show link or your e-show created. The next thing to do is invite people. It's so easy to just go to our friend list and just kind of check everybody off or check off only certain people, but we don't want to do that, and there's a number of reasons why. Although I've done it, I know it's easy, and sometimes we get lucky. We invite 200 and 25 show up and we have a great party, but I'm here to tell you that doesn't always work, okay? So keep in mind a couple of things. These Facebook parties are becoming more and more popular, and so sometimes people just get inundated with invitations, and that's not what they want, so they ignore them, or they just think they're just another number. People want to know that you really want them to hear what it is you have to say about this product or this company. Treat it like your home. You wouldn't put an ad in the paper and invite everybody who reads that publication into your home. Same type of thing. You know, you want to invite people that you know. You don't want strangers in your home. Although, if you invite a friend who brings a friend, we're okay with that. And Facebook, even though they're not coming into your home, you want people to know that you really want them there. Friends, family, teachers, neighbors, coworkers, whatever the case may be. We still may be inviting a couple hundred people, but better to do it personally on an individual basis. So face-to-face, over the phone, text, private message in Facebook, you know, at least to get the ball rolling. Once you have a few yeses, then if you really must, go ahead and do maybe a bit more of a mass invite. But initially, we want to invite people personally. The other reason that I recommend the personal invite as opposed to the mass is that not everybody sees those notifications, and therefore they don't get their invitation. I just happen to be somebody who spends a lot of time on social media. I have alerts on my phone, so I pretty much am up to speed on what's going on all day, every day. Not everybody's like that. Some people get on at one specific time every day, or maybe once a week. So there might be somebody who misses this party and misses an opportunity to book their own party, join the business, or buy books for their little loved ones simply because they didn't get on and see the invitation. So keep those things in mind. And then the other thing, I said something about we invite everybody, or maybe we don't invite everybody. We have a tendency to prejudge people. We don't invite them because we think we know what their response is going to be. Well, she doesn't have children, or, you know, money's real tight for her right now, or she doesn't like to read, or her kids are, you know, you fill in the blank. Point is, we cannot do that. We are denying somebody to make the decision for themselves. We don't know what, even as well as we know people, we don't know what's going on in their head. We don't know what their response is going to be. For example, one of you out there doesn't have children, but you love to read, and you decided to do this business. And you're not alone. There are plenty of other women in this business who do not have children, but they absolutely love books. They love children's books, and they love this business. So let's not prejudge. Let's not mass invite. At the same time, though, we want to invite everybody. So this is a numbers game, just like any other business. The more we invite, the better the chances of increasing sales for ourselves or for the hostess, and booking more parties. Because ultimately, keep in mind, we're going to grow and be successful if we continue booking parties, and of course, if people decide to do the business with us. So as much as we want sales, which in turn provide free books, and who doesn't love free books, if we want to be successful, we need to keep booking parties, and we need to invite people to the business. Okay, so now that we've created the Facebook event, we've created our e-show, we've invited everybody under the sun, we want to start downloading the pics and the scripts that we're going to use for the party. And I'm kind of going to give you the long version, if you will, only because up to this point, this is the only way I've done it. You can either go to our consultant toolbox and go to social media, click on Facebook parties, and download all the pictures there. Or you can also go to Facebook, go to our Transform page, and there's a pinned post at the top, and in it is a link to our Thrive documents. In there are folders, including a folder for Facebook parties, which will have the scripts that you'll want to use, as well as some of the same pictures and quite possibly more pictures. If you are having any trouble with the consultant toolbox or Thrive documents, please let me know so that I can guide you through it or send you what you need. Okay, so now you'll have everything that you need to do a party. And the way I've been doing it, the way many of us have been doing it, and certainly most people start out this way, is by copy and pasting. Now, the first time I did it, I went to somebody else's party, and I copied and pasted everything, and I put it in my own party. And then I just started saving my own parties. And so what I've been doing is I pull up two Facebook pages, and I have my current party as well as an older party. And we make this real simple. We number all of the posts because these parties tend to move really quickly. So you number the posts so that people know what order to go in. Yes. And two, for anybody that can't attend live and, you know, comes back a day or two later, they can also follow along and not feel completely lost. So you'll want to make sure when you're copying and pasting that you use the numbers. You may need to renumber them slightly depending on how you change the party. But so we use numbered posts. And so I will literally sit in front of my computer and copy and paste from an old party into a new party. I will change anything I need to, like the name of the hostess or the name of the event, minor things. But that's what you do, and it's pretty simple. And you give people anywhere from, you know, 30 seconds to 8 minutes, depending on whether this is a real quick post or maybe they're going to watch a video about some of the books. Because keep in mind, live doesn't mean they're watching us. We're literally posting pictures, videos that either we've done ourselves or most likely team leaders have done, and we're simply using them. Make sure, and not just in Facebook parties, but anytime you're doing anything with the business, that you get permission. If it's on Thrive Documents, then it's up for public use within our team. But make sure in any other event that you get permission to use somebody's picture or video. Okay, so we've got the event, we've got the link, which that will be one of our numbered posts. And when we get to the shopping part, we will post that link, and that way people will go there to shop. Why is it important that we have this e-show link? Well, let's say I'm doing a party for Mary Scarry, and we get to the shopping part, and everybody goes to my web page, and they look at the books, and everybody puts orders in. That's great. I'm thrilled. I've just had a $500 party. I'm super excited, except that doesn't help Mary. Why? Because it simply went to my web page. What happens when we create an e-show is it is specific to the hostess, whether it's ourselves or somebody that's hosting a party. So when I put the link to Mary Scarry's e-show, everybody shops there, and that way, now Mary has a $500 party, and she gets free books on that, which is good for her, and of course it's still good for me. But I want to make sure that my hostesses get the benefit. And I also want to make sure that I get the benefit when I'm the hostess. $500 orders, worth of orders on my web show or on my website is amazing. Yay, I'm happy. That's a lot of sales. I'm thrilled. However, I don't get any free books that way. I like free books just as much as everybody else. You can see behind me this way in the white bookshelf back there. It's all Usborne and Kane Miller books, and that's not even all of them. I've run out of room. But I love books, and I love Usborne and Kane Miller books, and I want to keep getting more, and I want free books too. So when I'm a hostess, I have my own e-show so that everybody shops specifically through that link, and when it's done, I get all the free books. So, Facebook event, e-show link. We've invited everybody under the sun. We've done all of our prep work, and we're going to copy and paste. Keep in mind, too, back it up a little, in those 2 or 3 days before the party, we will be posting pictures and giving people little bits of information to to entice them and make sure that they want to attend the party, and also just to get people to interact. And after the party, if you close it that night, great. If you keep it open for a day or two or a little bit longer, you want to continue to post so that anybody that maybe missed a live event can come back, follow along, and still get their orders in. Another thing that we typically do, and if you're just getting started and just don't feel like you can do it, don't worry about it. It's not like a rule or regulation. It's just something that most consultants do, but again, in time. It's not something you have to do right off the bat. But one way to get people involved is by having a raffle or a drawing. This could be for a free book. It could be for free shipping. Typically, we offer free shipping when they're placing a rather large order, like place an order for $75 tonight or $100 or whatever the case may be. Or maybe you're giving them the length of the party, but it has to be a $150 order, or they have to book a party. The sky's the limit. Use your imagination. If your imagination's lacking, ask me. Ask somebody in Transform. Everybody that I've talked to has amazing ideas of what you can do for raffles, games that you can play, prizes that you can give away. It's pretty easy stuff. Two more things. One, it's so important that we hostess coach our hostesses. So right now, for those of you that are just getting started and having your kickoff party, I'm going to be hostess coaching you, because even though you're the consultant, you're also the hostess. So I need you guys to pay attention to the things that I'm saying and the things that I ask you, not only so that you have the most successful party that you can, but so that the next party you do for your hostess, you can coach her the same way. Basically, these are things like making sure that you're inviting, making sure that you're interacting with those pre-party pictures, those questions that get people interacting, that you're sending reminders, things like this. So I will talk individually with you guys more about hostess coaching, but that's going to be so important to the success of your party, and that you interact with your hostess during the party, and that you continue to keep her very involved after the party. These just make for great events. And it ensures that, you know, other people book parties and that we just continue having more and more parties. Okay, so basically that is the Facebook party. But the last thing is Cinch Share. This is the easy way to do it. So everything that I just talked about, Cinch Share makes it even easier than it already is. I have not tried it yet, but I'm getting ready to go to the site, check it out, and start using it myself, because it really is a time saver. I don't know a whole lot about it yet, other than we basically spend a little bit of initial time putting all of our pictures and scripts into this site, and then we schedule our parties and how we want things to go, and Cinch Share does all the work for us. Because I don't know much more than that, and I don't want this to go too much longer, and I don't want to confuse everybody, after this, if you haven't already seen it, go to Transform. Check out the post that Megan put on about Cinch Share. She included a video that Tabitha did that teaches us more about Cinch Share. And then by all means, check it out. If you're not ready for it yet, great, no worries. Copy and pasting still gets the job done. But if you are looking to do a lot of parties, or you want to save yourself a whole lot of time, I highly recommend checking out Megan's video, Tabitha's video, and then checking out Cinch Share. So I hope that I have helped everybody understand how Facebook parties work, and good luck, everybody. Go team.